Comstock. I'm from Salt Lake City, Utah. I am in Chile for my very first time. I'm in Santiago right now, and we're gonna go up and do the Roxy Snow Jam. Me on a pair of skis when I was 2 years old. So I skied until I was about 12 years old. Mm-hmm. And then I found the passion of snowboarding, caught on like wildfire, and I snowboarded, well, until now. Into another chapel. Now she's walking down the aisle. It feels just like home. I think the thing I like the most is having my group of friends and taking laps through a park and building a jump and hitting it together, and the accomplishment of learning. That day that you land that new trick, it just puts a smile on your face for days. And I think like with this weekend, I'd love to help put that smile on those girls, just learning and progressing and pushing themselves. I think throughout the career, the biggest challenge being a female snowboarder is getting people to back you, like fund you. With a lot of movie projects we've tried to do, it's very hard to find money and sponsors to support it. They would rather give their money to a male project than to a female project. It is a challenge at the end of the day to have these huge companies be like, why do we want to support women when we have this man's team? So it's a challenge. My advice is just the same thing I did. Go out every single day. Use, you know, the runs. They have all these, like, we call them side hits. So when you're going down the hill, there's always, like, on the side, these little jumps. My biggest thing is to take those little jumps and also the little bumps that are in the hill, and always practice like spinning, like front threes, cab threes, backside 180s, frontside 180s. And if you're always going down and just bouncing around, like moving around, when you hit, it's gonna make you feel that much more comfortable for hitting bigger stuff, bigger jumps. And that's how I learned. All the jumps I can do now on the bigger jumps, I learned just from going down the little hill and just trying to hit those little side hits. The daylight comes, do you feel it? Leave your bag of bones underneath your bed. No way, no way. I was there the day that that happened with Sarah. And she was doing what she loved. I don't know if she was risking that moment, but she was there doing what she loved. And seeing her with that smile on her face, dropping in, doing her favorite trick, there's always a consequence that you just don't know about. It's the unknown consequences. And I look up to her to this day, and from her accident, I don't want to say I've become more scared. It makes me more determined to know, like, to keep pushing the women's sport forward.